Have you ever wanted to watch a terrible Kindergarten Cop ripoff from the mid-90s, which was also a PSA for the DARE program and to keep kids off the streets, out of gangs, and away from drugs? Then look no further than Kindergarten Ninja. Kindergarten Ninja sports an insanely mediocre execution overall, and there is no way anyone could take this in a serious manner to make their children sit down to absorb this material as a way to educate them about the dangers of substance abuse and joining gangs.
Each year, hundreds of police officers work side by side in classrooms teaching the DARE program. We salute the film's producers in their efforts to bring the DARE message into your home. Remember, by talking to your children and instilling good values, together we can all make a difference.
What you really have here is a film that contains grade school kids making fun of a guy that looks like a C-lister Craig T. Nelson, who is sentenced by a judge in court to be a teacher for 3 months as community service instead of, well, regular community service. He gets arrested for being a womanizer and for drinking too much in public, in which case for me, when I was in my early 20s, sounds like a solid Saturday afternoon. I never got arrested for any of that, but then again, I was never a professional football player named Blade Steel either. Kindergarten Ninja feels like the kids in the film just took a massive bottle of Elmer's glue and slapped whatever film cells the crew behind the scenes gave them together to try to make a cohesive piece about being a junkie and getting put in the slammer for public intoxication. It also feels like parts of Karate Kid, Three Ninjas, and Kindergarten Cop were sort of shoved in between the cracks where they missed gluing parts of it together as well. I don't know how you feel about a pro football player who drinks too much and hits on women all the time, but to me that just sounds like a regular guy that made it big into sports and is just having fun. What? The 90s are over. It's time to be real about these topics. After this radio intro, I was waiting for Three Dog to pop in.
Hi, energy.
Energy.
The South Bay's Hot 97.7.
You've got it locked in to Hot 97.7. This is Joe Cunningham, your rock jock.
Hello, Capital Wasteland. This is Three Dog. Ow! Coming to you loud and proud from Galaxy News Radio.
Did Blade Steel just steal candy from a random kid?
My baby, baby, baby.
Is she really talking about French fries here?
Can you believe I get this free for just 2 season tickets? Hey, you like French fries?
I love French fries.
My God, heaven is a weird place.
Morning, Bruce. Don't forget, you don't have much time.
Good morning, Bruce. Still working the kicks.
Hello, Bruce. You look very, very good.
Good morning, Bruce.
Morning, Bruce.
Good morning, everyone.
I haven't seen fighting this bad since the arcade game Pit Fighter.
Oh no, we got the right
cut. Yeah.
Purple Dragon goes to sea. Wave heavy, light clouds. Fight up the Viper. Wax on. Wax off. Thunder and lightning. Hasta la vista, baby.
Okay, let's go over this one more time. You're an angel, and I'm a womanizer, sinner, gambler, loser, right?
And I'm also a Craig T. Nelson lookalike. I think Bruce likes kids a little too much.
That's right. I understand you have to do community work for school.
Yeah, I have to register for my assignments today. 3 stupid months of that stuff, though, and I'm out of there.
Perfect. That's where we'll start. I love kids. They have all the emotional content.
This is a horrible attempt at ripping off Kindergarten Cop. I'm pretty sure I know what song is playing in Blade Steel's head right about now.
It's nice to meet you, Blade. I'm Linda.
Linda, it's nice to meet you too. Hey, Linda, are you free for dinner tonight?
I'm afraid not.
Well, how about a movie? Or coffee? French fries. Everybody likes French fries.
You're very sweet and funny, but I'm afraid you're not my type.
Well, what's your type?
These kids are hilarious.
All right, everyone. My name is Blade Steel. Does anyone know who I am? All right, you.
You're the reason my dad lost $50 from my Uncle Scott. He said the only balls you can throw.
That's great. Next?
You're Blade Steel from the San Francisco Gold Rush.
That's right.
My mom says you're a gorgeous hunk and super fine. Even though you lost against New Orleans because you didn't beat the quarterback on a third and long pattern.
Okay, thank you.
I have to go to the bathroom.
Me too!
Oh, that's enough. Hold it down. Honey, are you okay?
你好吗? 你叫什么名字?
My dad told me why you're here.
Why is that?
You got arrested, because you're an alcoholic.
I thought you were going to hurt this guy, not embarrass yourself.
I could kick this guy's butt any day of the week.
What? Please, come try. Hi.
This is crazy. I'm going to hurt this guy. He can't even see me.
Shoes, please.
Wave hands like clouds. Bite of the Viper.
What?
Karate Kid, part one. I was better this morning.
Quick, forget Blade Steel. Call Rocky, Colt, and Tom Tom.
What happened to all the money?
I must have lost it.
Well, you must have lost it. Perhaps we have a hole in our pocket. Or are we getting high on our own supply?
No!
I can't believe this, Joey. After all the effort I've given you, all the time, all the love, is this how you repay me? Is this how you repay me? Hey, Stone, come over here and show this young man what happens to people that take advantage of Hector Machete.
Street Fighter 2? Hell yeah.
Hold it down. Now what do you guys want to do today?
Let's play Street Fighter 2.
Yeah, that's cool.
That's only a game. Don't you guys want to play something that's real? Oh, I get it. You guys want to play Street Fighter because it's dangerous, and they go around beating each other up, right?
Yeah.
Well, I've got something that's even better than Street Fighter. How would you guys like to learn karate?
I think what you just said means you can hear very well, not that you can see, even though you're blind.
This is my friend, Master Chosen One.
Why does he wear glasses?
Because he's blind.
Oh, he can't see? That's too bad.
Just because I am blind does not mean I cannot see. For example, you have a cold.
How did you know?
I can tell by the way you talk. I hear you sniffle.
You mean you don't know about Buzz?
No, what's Buzz?
It's a new synthetic drug. All the kids know about it. Most won't talk about it. They get recruited by these gang members to sell the stuff and they get hooked. Fast money, fast highs.
That's crazy. These are just kids.
I know. But we won't have to worry about it anymore.
Why is that?
Because there's a new sheriff in town, and his name is Blade Steel.
Kindergarten Ninja is for sure a product of its time. Even back in the early to mid-90s, there were plenty of characters, TV specials, and movies that motivated children to stay healthy and away from the dark halls of substance abuse, but I cannot see this offering as something that could have been taken seriously for that subject matter even back then. I was somewhere between 3rd and 4th grade when Kindergarten Ninja was originally released, and I don't think that even I would have been able to take it beyond a hilariously bad martial arts film that may or may not have been a cheap knockoff of Kindergarten Cop and Three Ninjas.
I'm in! We have no time to waste!
Please.
We must begin training today, right?
Right.
You're so cool.
I would really only say to look this up on Tubi because of how piss poor the overall package is here, while drinking a six-pack and to have a good confused laugh. Zits and Zombies, you already know that there are plenty of other ninja movies that are way beyond the level of how bottom of the cask this is, so why bother? Put on some sweats and turn up that 1984 LP by Van Halen. Blade Steel is hot for teacher.
Gather around. Let me introduce you to some people here. The newest addition to the Hector Machete security team, the Turf Ninjas. Funny guys, they can run, they can jump, they can do karate like I want you guys to do, huh?